Sorry.
Alright. Let's say I grab my purse. I put it on my shoulder. I grab some tissues.
Let's go over here and grab some sunglasses. I'm gonna grab my earbuds. What if I need to listen to some music?
You know, you never know. There's some water. I might get thirsty along the way. Stick up all this stuff. There's a cane. What if I break my leg? I can use this. Might need it for the journey. Bring me your Bible, Tim. I didn't at all plan on this. That's a nice Bible. I sure would like to hold it. I'd kind of like to read it, too. Maybe you could just tell me what you think of it. Maybe then that'll help me along my journey, right?
Oh, preach it, sister.
What's going to happen if I don't let go of this stuff?
Amen.
Put your Bible down and start trying to take this stuff from me. You can have the cane. I'm going to let you have my purse. You can lay it down. You can do whatever you want to do with it. But what if I keep this one? What if I don't want to let go of the tissues? What if I've got fears and doubts and insecurities and I'm scared to death and I think I'm going to start bawling at any given moment, so I don't want to let go of these? This is my safety net. This is what I'm going to hold on to. Try to take it. What happens? Am I ever going to hold that Bible? Am I ever going to know the word and the life and the goodness and the promises he has for me if I do not give this to him and take his word in exchange? Am I ever going to know what he has for me? Am I ever going to see the freedom of the Lord if I do not give him what I'm holding on to?
Glory.
Yeah.
We have bondages. We have fears. We have things that are trying to hinder the Spirit of the Lord. And until and unless those things get dropped, he is not going to set you free, because he can't until you let him.
Amen.
God can do anything he wants if you'll surrender. But he's not going to force himself, because God is a gentleman.
Uh-huh.
God is not going to start yanking stuff out of your hands until
Amen.
You say, here, Lord, take it.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
then you can grab the word. And then you can learn what he has for you and what his plans are. He says in Jeremiah, he knows the plans he has for you.
Yes.
Plans to prosper you. Plans to give you hope and a future. If that is what he has for you, why would you hang on to a box of tissues?
Yeah.
Why would we hang on to a cane? Those things mean nothing. Just like the things in our life mean nothing unless we let go of them and give them to God.
Yeah.
Then he'll put value in them that we never saw before.
Right.
He'll make things better than we ever could have dreamed.
Yeah.
I don't know why on earth that's on my heart. I know this was weird.
And I'm
all get out. I still have a song to sing that I want to sing. So, y'all worship with me.
That's your sermon, but that going home.